High School in majestic Manoa. The battle of ILH powerhouses. The Iolani Red Raiders are coming into the Punahou Buff and Blue. My name is Tony McInerney. Joining me tonight is former national champion from Pepperdine and current girls varsity volleyball coach Peter Balding. Peter, welcome.
Thank you, Tony. Quite an introduction there. Thank you.
It's all the truth.
Totally unnecessary. And this is going to be an exciting match tonight. Both teams are coming off of good wins last week. Iolani had a great match against Maryknoll, 1-3 on Saturday, and Punahou played a pretty good scrappy team, Maryknoll, down at their place last week. And so they're both kind of primed and ready. And the first big test for both of them in the ILH.
For people out there listening, we're going to get into the starting lineups, and then we'll talk more in depth about some keys to the match and players to watch. So we are now doing our introductions. Number one, Clint Hamada, senior. Number four, Charles Yoon, also a senior.
Number nine, Logan Nowak.
Number nine, Logan Nowak, also a senior.
Number 10, Colin Tseng.
Number 10, Colin Tseng, senior.
Number 11, Harrison Lum.
Number 11, Harrison Lum, senior.
Number 12, Tyler Cundiff.
12, Tyler Cundiff,
number 17,
senior.
Gabriel Vega.
The lone junior, number 17, Gabriel Vega, otherwise known as Gabo. Coaches Mike Amon and Alan Rosen. Starting lineup for Punahou Buff and Blue.
Number four, Sean Grubner.
Number four, Sean Grubner, 6'2 outside hitter, junior.
Number seven, Brandon Pitzer.
Number seven, Brandon Pitzer.
Number eight, Kekai Nuhuhiva.
Number eight, Kekai Nuhuhiva, senior libero.
Number 13, Ben Lamb.
Number 13, Ben Lamb, senior middle blocker.
Number 14, Tui.
Tui Leta, number 14, freshman outside
15,
hitter.
Tyler Kubota.
Number 15, Tyler Kubota, setter.
Number 16, Griffin Bowen.
And number 16, Griffin Bolin.
Head coach for the Buff and Blue is Rick Toon. He's assisted by Stein Metzger and Brandon Kikuchi.
Rick Toon, head coach, followed by Stein Metzger and Brandon Kikuchi. Now, Peter, a couple things to look for us on Iolani's side. Who we got looking at probably a standout tonight?
Well, I think, you know, Logan Nowak is kind of a four-year letterman. Tyler Cundiff as well. You know, those two guys are their go-to guys, and you're going to see them kind of carrying the load. Logan with his setting and hitting when he's in the front row, and Tyler, he's a big middle blocker, and you look for him to control the net. You know, they got to have some good performances. I talked to Mike Among before, and they got to have some good performances out of Colin Tseng and Charles Yoon in terms of passing. They got to be able to handle the Punahou serves, and if they can do that, they feel pretty comfortable about what they're going to do.
For sure, if they can handle the jump serve, then they can get their offense going. And then on Punahou side, Peter, who do you think we should be taking a look at for our friends out there in webcast land?
Well, you know, the battle in the middle is going to be a good one. You got Ben Lamb and Tyler Cundiff kind of going against each other. Actually, they're both committed to go to SC next year, and so you're going to kind of see those two guys doing battle. You kind of wonder, you know, what Tui's going to be like as a freshman, his first kind of big, you know, really important match. And you know, my guess is he'll be have a little bit of the nerves, even though he's played at a real high level in the summertime in clubs and stuff.
Right.
You know, we'll see what he can do and what's going to happen. So
always neat to see. There's on the starters, you got five seniors and a junior for Iolani, and the majority of the Punahou is going to be seniors as well. So Tui's going to be playing with a bunch of elder statesmen. And I wouldn't be surprised, Peter, if the first serve of the game actually goes to Tui and see if he can pass that ball.
You know what? It's probably a pretty good play. See what he can do.
Back to serve Clint Hamada. Kekai, perfect receive. Middle set. And that's an error by Pitzer. What'd you see on that, Pete?
Well, you know, it's a great great block by their middle over there at Iolani, and Brendan just tried to turn it just a little bit too fine. So
Clint Amata back to serve, pass by Sean Grubner. Throw down. We call that a repeat set.
You know, I love that play. I think that what you're going to see out of Tyler Kubota on the Puno side is somebody who's a very seasoned setter. I mean, he ran a 5-1 and won a state championship last year. So, you know, he's a seasoned vet and runs the show really well.
Great set. Jump serve by Tyler. I mean, excuse me, Tui Tui let it down the line. Logan Nowak could not handle that. Popped over by the libero. A nice outside set. One up for Sean Grubner. Dug up by Gabriel Vega. Free ball coming. Let's see what we do here. They do here. Matt missed timing. Great dig by the big guy. Back set to Logan. He was a little early, but he got the kill off Sean Grubner.
Yeah, so you see, you know, he's our go-to guy. He had a long rally, a great rally. You saw that, you know, the effect of going in the middle early by Punahou, it held Harrison Lum in the middle and got him one-on-one on the outside and pretty good ball control for this early in the match.
I liked it. I liked the set by Tyler. I liked the set by the setter for Iolani, if I can get his number. Jump serve just out. Number one is Clint Hamada. He's their setter. Looking like we got Sean Grubner, Ben Lamb, and Griffin Bolin in the front row going up against Harrison Lum, Gabriel Vega, and Logan Nowak. Back to serve Kekai Nuihiva. The roller out of bounds.
Yeah, so you see this, you know, this serving game real early, Tony. You know, a little bit of the nerves. Guys trying to make it too fine instead of just putting the ball in the court. You know, given a lot of, you know, we've had two service errors already, so.
I usually say just try to let the game come to you. Don't force it until later, then you get your rhythm. High, hard hit by Grubner, two up. Outside to Gabriel Vega, number 17 with a high. Back
great
middle
play
by Tui, and then we're gonna have free ball here. Hard middle set, and a two up commit block by Grubner and Ben Lamb, but Tyler couldn't have handled that.
Well, and you know what? That's one of the plays that Michael Mong said that we have to make that play in order to win this match. That easy free ball coming over, the pass was right on target, and they were able to go to the middle, set Tyler Cundiff, you know, nice and high, so.
And it was a pretty smart set, and that was a held ball, but.
Yeah, I don't know if I agree with that, Tony. No. You know, that first contact is supposed to be real liberal, you know, the calls, but hey, you know. It happens. You just got to deal with it and move on.
I agree. From this level to the next level, it's got to stay consistent.
Boy, they're going right at Tui, aren't they?
They are going right at. It's a perfect dig by the libero. And another middle set. Dug ball by the libero. Pipe play. Tui, great dig by Colin Sang. And he's going to hit this ball just out. Good defense, both sides.
Yeah, you know, there's some good volleyball being played right early. You know, you see kind of the metal or the moxie of Tui. You know, they're serving him, they're going after him. He's hitting kind of a bad set in the middle of that play and putting it in the court, just giving his team a chance to get back in the flow. And
I look at his facial expressions, he's not fazed by anything. He just plays the game.
No, the boys played at a very high level.
Tandem play.
Ooh, nice little play
nice
there.
Nice block on the outside by Alvin Kwok, and a big kill by Gabriel Vega. There's no fear against this Punahou team being in their Punahou gym right now.
No, and I like the fact that, you know, that he went right back to him. Set him right back. Who's that? Clint Hamada went right back to Vega and gave him a second chance to put the ball away.
Jump serve Logan Nowak with some heat. Pretty decent pass. Ben Lamb with a little error there. I thought that play was good play. There was a one-on-one situation. It went well, but just heated a little too low.
Well, you got a new setter in the game. You know,
yeah.
Tyler Kubota doesn't play the front, so you got Lowell Tong coming in. The flow of things is a little bit different. You know, it looked like he was a little bit tight, that, you know, in terms of his nerves. The set was never really got to the height that Ben's comfortable with. And, you know, Ben wanted to get a good swing on the first one, so.
That's a very good point, Pete, because the majority or many people, teams-wise, they set a 5-1. 5-1, you have consistent one person setting the whole time. 6-2, you got to adapt to two setters. So it just goes with what's given to you. You know, if the team needs two setters, then they're going to do it. Certainly at the next level, NCAA men's, they're going to go 5-1. But we'll see how this Punahou team can adapt.
Well,
having two setters.
I think that coming out of this, I think they're going to want to go to the middle again. You know, is it... You know, I know that, Rick, he likes going back to the middle, especially out of a timeout. They've been passing well to get it to him. I look for them to, you know, to go it because they've got Iolani jumping in the middle, and they like that. And I think they feel confident that, Ben can move the ball around against Tyler Cundiff and Gabriel Vega. So we'll see out of this, see how well they pass.
And we'll see if Mike actually figures this out. Maybe he'll go with a commit on the middle. Logan Nowak just keeps it in. Kekai, perfect pass. And they do go to the middle with two up. Great set, a little wide on the outside with Gabriel Vega. High ball to Grubner. Grubner, great diving dig by Logan Nowak.
Oh my goodness.
Logan Nowak with a heck of a dig. That is a big time defensive play.
Well, and smart hitting by Sean Grubner. You know, he had the smaller blocker out on the left. He turned the thing down the line, and Logan Nowak made a great dig, and Ben Lam just alert at the net, you know, knocked it down. So
jump serve. Colin Peros outside to Brett Chrisman. Tui with the dig up. Tui with an outside set. Another dig. Looks like Ilani's got their number on the positioning in back middle. Kekai with a good free ball. Looks like Greg Natori, if I know his last name, is calling this game a little tad too tight, Peter, just for my liking. First contact's pretty liberal.
Yeah, but you know what? It's pretty consistent. I mean, he's made the same call, and you know.
Yep. I agree, but
so we'll see
if it loosens up. Gabriel Vega with a missed time jump serve. That'll come with time. He's a junior. He's a basketball player. Played a lot of hoops. I think he's just learning to get his feet under him in volleyball.
Yeah, you know, he's only going to get better with his size and whatnot. But I'm impressed right now with the Iolani side in terms of handling the ball, digging the ball. They're getting a lot of hands on balls that the Buff and Blue are swinging hard at. Here you can see Colin
High ball Singh. Hit. Ben Lam with a ripping jump serve down the line, and
Colin Singh
came up with he jumps real well. They're going to have to time him a little bit differently. I think he kind of started to hit on his way down.
Well, you know, when you got a jumper like that, you got to delay. You got to wait, and then, you know, time it like you say.
Tyler Cundiff looks like a jump floater. To Tui, he handles that pretty well. That's a little bit of an offset. He's coming a little tad early. Communication. Shoots it out, Lowell Tang with a one-on-one set. Brett Chrisman wanted that, but he didn't get his left arm over, I think, a little bit enough, but the hitter will usually win that, right? One-on-one.
The hitter's supposed to win. Somebody of Tui's caliber is gonna win that. You know, Brett, to make the adjustment, he's gotta step in and jump into the angle on that in order to take that away, take away the big part of the court.
Tyler Kubota with a jump serve in the net.
You know, Tony, what I'm seeing right now is the flow is that, you know, the Puno team is kind of sputtering a little bit. You know, Iolani's already played a really tough match on Saturday. They're into the competitiveness, the competing, and they're competing a little bit better right now.
You can kind of see that. It's a one-on-one set with a solo block.
Oh,
and he's going to get another swing. Griffin Dolan, perfect dig by Logan Nowak, and he's going to go up and crush that down the line with a touch
on the play.
We're looking at 11 serving 6.
Yeah.
Iolani's gone ahead by 5. There has been one timeout used by Rick. Games are to 25, I believe.
Yes, they are. All three games. If it goes three games, all three are to 25. You know, great play, great adjustment by the Iolani blockers. You know, there he was one-on-one. We just talked about him needing to move in and take that angle.
Well, middle set. That's a heck of a set. Tui came up with a little bit of off pass, and Tyler Kubota fed the middle of the pitcher. Pitcher was up early enough to get that.
Well, you know, here you got Tyler Kubota, who's got a little bit, you know, a little more seasoning, a little bit more moxie. He's gonna push the middle. He knows that's the bread and butter. We're gonna work inside out, so to speak.
Tough jump floater by Tui. Tui Leta. Logan's just gonna pop that for a free ball. Kekai will gobble that up. Outside set. Looks like their communication is not together. I think he's calling for a different set.
Well, he was coming in to hit some sort of a combination, and, you know, either he'd had that communication with the other setter before he came in and whatnot. So, you know, we'll see.
Colin Singh back to serve. He does have a pretty good vertical, and his jump serve is in, passed by the middle pitcher. You don't see that much. Griffin Dolan, and that's his second lift call.
No, he called a net on the Iolani blocker on that.
Okay, yeah. Thank you, Pete.
I thought it was a lift call, too. I was like, oh, my goodness. I'm not sure that we're watching the same game here.
It's a strict referee show here. We have Kekai Nuhiva. He does have a pretty decent jump serve. Heavy topspin. Shank pass by the libero, and that's a back set to Logan. High hands. Peter, tell me something about defense. Defense, I like to see guys stopped when the ball is contacted.
Well, yeah, I mean, anytime, you know, a guy's swinging at the ball, you need to be stopped so that you, whether you're in the right or the wrong position, you can react to where the ball goes. And, you know, what you're seeing is Iolani is making some, you know, great high percentage plays, and the Buffalo Blues not coming up with the dig.
I see that. It looks like their back row for Iolani is working in good sync with the front row blockers. Back rows are stopped and stationary, and they're getting a lot more digs than the Punahoys right now.
Very much so. You can tell they've got the Buffalo scouted. They've got their, you know, their blockers lined up, and the diggers are in the holes and the seams of the block, and they're doing a real nice job.
9 serving 13. Lowell Tang coming in.
Tong,
my apologies. 2 up on that. Logan didn't really have anywhere to go. Tight set, high set. Ben Lamb and Sean Grubner will get that.
Interesting to see here, Tony, in this part of the game now. This is where Iolani kind of made their break on the Buff and Blue, you know, when Lowell Tong came in the last time. So we'll see if he's made some adjustments with setting coach Stein Metzger over there and, you know, get him on a different kind
perfect
of role.
Perfect set. Though. Tyler Cundiff will attract a lot of attention, thus giving Gabriel Vega the one-on-one opportunity, but he will detonate on that.
He's got to put that ball away. It's 6'7" or whatever he is with the arms like he's got. You know, and a great hit by him. Great hit. You know, saw the angle and, you know, did a fantastic job.
And Colin Tseng is doing what he needs to do. He's passing perfect. He's making kills and he's digging a lot of balls. Jump serve by Logan. Handled appropriately. Ben Lamb gets dug. He's touching at a high level.
Oh, I like that.
He's got good footwork, Pete, on that. He had to get off the net and come in for another attack.
Yeah, and I like Lowell pushing the middle on that. You know, when he was in the first time, it was low, and it didn't get, you know, Ben into his full reach. You can see there both times Ben, you know, went over the block, even though Iolani in the first one made a great dig.
Colin Perros with kind of a hybrid serve, we call that. It's got a mix. It's got a little top spin. It's got a little warble on it.
Yeah, and you know what? This is a rotation that Puno has to score in because they've got Brett Chrisman, who is the weakest of their outside hitters, out on the left. And if they don't pass well, they're forced to go to him, and it puts Puno block in a real advantageous position. So here again, bad pass.
This is a tight pass again. It's a back row attack, possibly. Tui's going to get tooled on the outside, and I think what they're calling for is that Logan was below the net. He tried to set the ball.
Yeah, but I don't agree with that.
No, I don't either.
I think that he was above the net, and, you know, the ball broke the plane of the net. You know, bad call, but, hey, those things happen. You got to move on.
You got to roll with it.
So now Rick Toon told me that these next two rotations that Iolani are in are the ones that they want to score. When Logan Nowak is middle back and left back, that they feel that they've got a mismatch. So we'll see what happens
here.
We
got Colin Tseng and Brett Chrisman on the outside. These guys are digging balls. Tui Tuilet is unfazed. He looks like he's a seasoned veteran as a freshman. I mean, I don't know if he's 14 or 15. I think he's nearing 15 years old.
Well, it's been my experience that anybody that has single name recognition has to be pretty good.
He's got to be pretty good.
You know? You talking
is that why everybody called you Pete a lot?
No.
Back in the
day?
No,
that was not why.
Ben Lamb, jump serve down the line, handled decently by Colin Tseng. Colin Tseng, a little under the ball. And he's just doing the look angle and twisted line off Alvin Kwok. I don't think Alvin was pressing his right hand to the opposite corner as well as it should.
Well, set kind of died a little bit on the inside, and it looked like they reached, you know, inside for it rather than staying, you know, kind of set in their line position.
Tough pass by Tui went head. That's a six pack. He not only passed that on a nail.
He passed that. He had kind of a, you know, mediocre set, and he went over the block and six packed the guy in the middle back.
Ian Wong got a little haircut there, but let's see. We got 14 serving 16. So I'm looking at body language, Peter. I like to look at that, and this Iolani squad does not look as though they are in any trouble.
No.
Outside set to Colin Sand.
Very much so.
And the big block by Griffin Bolin and Pitzer.
Well, here's Iolani's weakest rotation. Okay, you got their weaker of the two outside hitters in Colin Sand. You have Harrison Lum in the middle and Brett Chrisman on this side. So there's not a whole lot, you know, for the Buff and Blue. Right. They make a great play by Harrison Lum. That's a great deep hit. You know, they're getting out of the two rotations that Rick, you know, thought that they could score in. They're not scoring a whole lot of real points in those rotations. So advantage Iolani.
Definitely. Tyler Kubota had a nice little jump serve there, but they gobble that up and they're set in the middle. Back to serve here. We
have Clint Hamada.
Good pass by Tui. Two up on Pitzer, but Pitzer, nice help by Logan Nowak and Harrison Lum.
Harrison Lum and Logan Nowak. Boy, they were all over that.
They were all over it, but Brandon Pitzer out-muscled them. But they weren't over the net, Peter. You know what I'm saying? They weren't over that. That would have been a good block, but they weren't over the net. Colin Tsang is getting a lot of sets.
Olin,
that's going to be called as a double contact as well as it should be.
Yeah, you know, he mishandled that ball.
Yeah.
Great hit by Colin Tsang, you know, and we'll see. You know, this ball's been going to Tui on this. He's been serving that side of the court. We'll see if he serves that side again. Makes it difficult for the setter to have to track the ball in this rotation.
Jump floater, Colin Tsang, Kekai with a decent pass. Back pipe hit. What a dig. That's a heck of a dig.
Oh, my goodness.
Charles Yoon got in the spot.
Golly, what a play.
You like to see those defensive plays right there.
But, hey, you know what? They're going to the freshman out of the back row at 18-60 in the first game, needing this game here.
Amazing. Kekai Nuhiva with the triple bounce. He does his ritual. Heavy topspin. Logan handles that perfectly. It's a late one with the throwdown. Tui does a collapse dig.
Oh, my goodness.
Gabriel Vega. Hey, Peter, that's a dig kill, by the way. That will go down as a dig and a kill.
You know, the kid can't do anything wrong right now.
Not really.
You know, he's in the front row, and he's scoring real points. He's in the back row. He's making plays like that. You know, this kid, I didn't realize this kid was that good.
Nor did I. I had heard about it. I played against his father, Larry, back in the day. Larry was awesome. Played for the Sons of Samoa, and was a big jumper. But he says, oh, Tony, I got this kid. You know, he's pretty good. I met Tui when he was about 10. Heard about him. Now I finally get to watch this kid. Boy, am I impressed. Not only with his physical, but his attitude and his mental demeanor is solid.
All right, so I'm looking for Michael Mong here now. They're passing okay in this rotation. You know, I think they're going to go back to Cundiff out of this. You know, he's in the, you got both he and Vega up in the front. I look to, you know, them to go to him.
What would you do? I mean, this is a...
Oh, I'm sorry. Harrison Lum is in the middle. But you know what? The kids hit two high-percentage shots. I'd go to him. You know, I'd go ahead and set him. You know, make Punahou commit in the middle out of the timeout.
We'll see what they do. Let's see what's up their sleeve. All depends on the pass, Peter. And that pass is on money.
Perfect.
And they are going to the middle. Peter, you called it. Well, when you can pass a nail and you got a big jumper in Harrison Lum... We're at 19 serving 18. That was a heck of a play. And of course, Peter, that was a great call by you.
Hey, the kid's had three sets. He's put all three in the court, and he's got two kills. So he's hitting 6-6-6, you know? So
Charles Yoon with the jumpy. Sean Grubner passes it to his side. He's going to fly over the block. And a lift by Tui.
That's a good call. That's a good call.
That does not get called in the NCAA, I just got to tell you. That will not get called in college.
Well, you see Iolani here now. They're serving Sean Grubner, who's in the front. He's the attacker in the front, the outside hitter in the front. And then he's got to go out.
Another ace.
Yeah, so they're making him do two things here.
He's not moving his feet, Peter. I saw that his first step was backwards.
Yeah, that's a huge swing by Iolani. You know, it starts with the timeout. Great timeout by Michael Mong. So now... The little chess game.
Right.
Switches back to.
What do we do?
What do we do? Well, I think Rick, he adjusts his passing pattern, gets Sean Grubner out of the passing pattern, and then probably either goes to the middle or sets the ball back because the blockers over on this side are really good.
You got
Logan, who's a great right side blocker, and you got Cundiff close to him. I look for him to run kind of a 31-5 here and set the five.
Right. Pull the middle blocker towards the left front. You go overhead back, but we'll see. We got a substitution coming in.
Kupono Fay.
Shelly Fay. Shelly Fay, the PE
department chair. Okay,
son.
So they've gone to a four-man receiving this.
Charles Yoon with another jump serve, pretty perfect pass by Tui, and they're going to set Ben Lamb.
Yeah.
Ben Lamb detonates, and he's stoic. Can you see his face after that?
Yeah, and you know what?
He should get a little energized, but I like to see some energy, but he's a little too stoic.
I was a little surprised that that Gabriel Vega wasn't helping on that middle.
Yeah.
You know, given the pass being as good as it was.
Definitely. Lowell Tong back to serve with a jump floater. Let's see how effective that is. Gobbled up by Clint. Our Colin Tsang. Joust. Logan outside to Gabriel Vega. Goes high hands.
I think almost a great play by Kekai Nuuhiva.
I think our back middle, or the back middle for Punahou, was a little too shallow.
You know,
two up with the big guy.
Yeah, and you know, I guess they're, you know, they've been scouting him thinking that he's going to put the ball, you know, over and down. You know, they maybe need to make an adjustment here late in the game and make sure that they got that digger in the back.
22-19, rifling jump serve is going to be a little tight. Ben Lamb just gets housed. Actually, a commit block, big time block. Logan Nowak with a senior serve down the line to Tui. Senior versus freshman, I don't know.
You know, that was a great set, it was a great hit, and it was a great
block.
You know, sometimes you just gotta tip your hat to him.
Logan Nowak is unnerved.
Oh.
Ben Lamb hustles.
Way to track the ball.
And free ball here. Colin Tsang with a free ball pass, perfect. Kundiff gets two up. Libero.
Oh, what a pass.
That's a nail right there. Gabriel Vega goes high hands. He's hitting high hands. And Ben Lambs gets called for a net. Let's see, 24-19, Peter.
You know, late here in the game at 20, Iolani has made all the little plays and done it well. They've passed the ball perfect to the target. They've run the middle. Then they got a bad pass.
He went for it. Logan Nowak back to serve.
You know,
you got to go for it. You got a good cushion. No?
I don't like that.
Okay.
You got these guys on the ropes. I don't like giving them a sliver.
I see.
You know, I say put it in the court. They're
in
jail.
Court.
Yeah.
Colin Peros with a pretty good serve, high ball hit. Great dig by Kekai. Outside to Tui. He's going to kind of roll shot, finesse it. Logan's going to set back to the big guy again. And no block up. Tui is out of position. Game one, 25-20.
Boy, I tell you, Tony, I am really impressed with how Iolani played at 20. You know, they made all the little plays. They did some just fantastic stuff. You know, if Punahou is going to be in this match, they got to make those little plays down the stretch. And you know what? Rick was concerned about that, you know, to see in terms of nervousness and whatnot. So we'll see.
We'll see what kind of Pete, adjustments. I thought it was they probably were well scouted. We'll see how they come out. Joining us, though, now, State Player of the Year from Kamehameha Schools, Misty Ma'a. Thanks for joining us, Misty. What I was thinking is, wow, state champs last year again as a junior and MVP of the league. Tell me what that was like for you, that whole experience.
The experience was good coming out. We had big shoes to fill just because the teams before us had so much success, so I just feel like that was our motivation to help push us to where we needed to be.
And I know that the Kamehameha boys are going to be battling this year. Have you gotten a chance to see any of those guys play? Tell me what you think about what they're looking like in comparison to Iolani and Punahou.
I watched them play Iolani the last game, and it was a really close match. I think it could go either way, but they're both definitely really strong teams this year.
Interesting.
Hey, Misty, tell us a little bit. You know, you had a great season. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Player of the Year. So what are you doing now in the off season to, you know, prepare yourself for your senior season, which, you know, undoubtedly you wanna try and top what you did last year?
Well, I've been working out and just trying to better my game so that I can help the team out more next year, I think.
Good, and I assume you're playing club, and how's the club team? Tell us a little bit about the club team and how that's going.
I'm playing for Imiike, so Coach Scott Wong, and my team's like great. I love it. We have Ali Santi, Brigitte, Nikki Taylor. I don't know, it's just a bunch of fun.
Wow,
girls.
You got a little bit of an all-star team there.
Wow.
That must be pretty fun to be a part of that.
That's pretty fun.
Fantastic.
Are you doing some cross training as far as like, do you surf a little? Do you play beach volleyball? Do you hike? You run?
I run almost every night, and I should be lifting.
Should be lifting. For all you people out there, she's a dedicated worker. We look forward to watching you this season. It's going to be very exciting.
Thank you.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Misty.
Pete, we got 20 seconds to go here, Pete, and we'll see how they come out of the chute, both sides.
Well, I think that that Punahou's got to, they got to keep their middle going. They got to establish their middle. I think that, you know, the timing of their middle is definitely, the flow of it seems a little bit kind of herky-jerky to me. I like the fact they got three hitters, but I'd like to see them take a chance and they're not getting hurt by Ilani's hitting, I don't think, and blocking. I'd like to see Tyler Kubota stay in and run the 5-1. I think that it would send a different tempo and whatnot.
I am in all agreement. As you know, well, you taught me how to set the 5-1. That was back in 88. Peter Balding was a 5-1 setter, and I believe in the 5-1 system. So it just keeps your hitters level. It keeps them not having to adapt to two different human beings.
Well, yeah, and I know why Rick does it. You know, is that he's got a young team. You know, it has three attackers at all times, and it's, you know, we'll see what kind of adjustments they make.
Great serve by Tyler Kubota, offset by Logan. But look, that's about a 9-foot off hit with heavy topspin. He's a strong kid. Logan's pretty much a top of the ILH kayaker. He's a goalie for the Iolani soccer team.
The kid's a great athlete.
He's an unbelievable athlete. Great
family.
He was
a starting setter for the state championship team 3 years ago. You know, his volleyball pedigree is huge.
Tui with a great back from a great backspin by Tyler. Excuse me, Peter. He's climbing the ladder. He looks like he came in with some intent to detonate on that.
Well, he came ready to play. You know, the rest of the Buff and Blue have to kind of pick up the slack a little bit. You know, they can't just go to Tui. You know, Ilani is gonna, you know, they'll make adjustment. So
Tui with a big jump serve, and that's about in by 4 feet. And I don't think Colin Singh saw anything like that in the first game.
No, he didn't.
No, he didn't. You know, I don't think.
I think Rick's probably hoping, okay, let's go 23 more of those and, you know, we'll even things back up. And
wouldn't
whatnot.
That be nice? So,
nice adjustment by Colin Singh. He stepped to his right, backed up a little bit.
And he passes a pretty good nail outside to Gabriel Vega.
Oh, my.
His footwork looks pretty good for a big guy. I saw a good step close. Tell people out there what that means when I say step close there, Pete.
Step close means that they're finishing with their right and then their left. They can close with their right also, but it's a lot more natural for an outside hitter on the left side to close with their left.
Nicely said. Charles Yoon with a good serve. Go back row set to Tui. Outside.
Careful.
Grubner. Careful. He jumped. That was a tight set. We don't like to see any injuries. Sean Grubner actually did elevate vertically pretty well. But instead of hitting it off the block, he just twisted it out of bounds.
Well, it looked like he went just over and out, yeah?
Yeah, I think so.
So,
great pass by Kekai Nuhiva outside to Grubner again. And this is an overset detonation by
Kupono Fei.
See, that's a very cerebral play. Instead of trying to unleash and hammer it when you can possibly net, you just go up with one hand or two and just tap it down.
You know, I heard he had a fantastic last two matches in the Iolani tournament 2 weeks ago and has really kind of played himself into a position to be on the court. So that's exciting to see.
Back to serve, Kekai Nuhiva. He's kind of getting under that. I'd like to see him toss it more in front of him so he can get into his sweet spot. He's a little bit under it, not able to see the court.
Yeah, and if he was to position it for, you know, the corners, he'd have a little bit more court to work with rather than going right down the middle of the court. So
Logan Nowak back to serve. Pretty much easy spinner, too. He handles that effectively. Ben Lamb jumped like he was Michael Jordan. I think I saw his tongue sticking out. He was slathering. Anytime a middle is coming in hard on a good pass like that, you know he's
well,
happy.
Well, his number's 1-3 and not 2-3, so. But there again, Tyler Kubota, knowing that he's got, you know, the hot hand in Ben, so we'll see.
Lowell Tong, that's a back bump set to Gabriel Vega, and
he
does a smart play. I mean, he doesn't have an approach. He's not able to hit it with one hand. He just sets it over.
You know, the Raiders are doing a great job tonight of playing a very high percentage game. They're not trying to do anything too fancy. They don't have the set. They swing for the court. You're not seeing too many hitting errors or, you know, not a whole lot of serving errors. And just as I say that, Mr. Vega puts the ball on the net.
That happens in all sports. Baseball. Oh, we haven't seen him strike out in about a decade, and he strikes out.
Yeah.
Free throws. Happens every time. Here we go. We have a sub in. Colin Peros, their normal lefty, He's got a kind of a hybrid, and the hybrid is the half topspin, half floater. He doesn't really get true good contact. It's a lefty, so it's coming at you from a different angle. And that's a pretty easy jump serve. Handled not too well. These hitters, great dig by Kekai Nuhila.
What a play.
Lowell Tong, and Tui's gonna take a swing. That is
that's
a tight
over.
Pass, and
that's
Ben Lamb. What a play by Tui. It's a 15-foot ball. He has to step backwards, to step close, jumps, roll shots it in, and they make an error.
Yeah, and you know what? I'm noticing that they're starting to serve this Alden Wong, and he's starting to make some mistakes. I think that they need to keep it on him. You can see that's
right when we
play.
Say that. You have three big blockers in the front row. Ben Lamb, Tui. Tui lets an Alvin Kwok.
We got
and
a new
jumpster.
Sub coming in here.
We
and
got?
Kyle Kikina. Yeah, a little serving sub. We'll see how he does. First action tonight.
Sophomore. He's as fit as a fiddle. Paddler, beats volleyball player. Comes in, makes Tui struggle for that.
No.
And he scores a point off his serve. Kyle Kikina.
You know, Kyle Kikina, a little tidbit on him. He's a great waterman. Loves the surfing, the paddling, but he's a great skin diver.
Yeah,
little poke spear, little spear fish, you know, that kind of stuff.
He has an uncle, the Greg Arth, who has water polo at UCLA.
His mom,
Sydney, and he's got a brother, Greg Arth, All-American water polo player at UCLA.
Great sub. Got him one natural point, so here we go.
Ben Lamb, who's beefed up over the summer like we've talked about being earlier, he's trying to go for too much, Peter, on that jump serve.
Yeah, and you know, that's his second service error, I believe, of the night. I think Rick's got to look the next time at bringing somebody in to serve for him. So,
that's Clint Hamada.
No.
Clint Hamada, correct?
Yep.
First serve. High ball, back set, and that's stuffed straight down. Great cover by Lowell Tong. Popping it over, Alvin Kwok. Libero gets it decently enough to the... Logan Nowak's going to get blocked by Tui.
Oh, what
Tui
a
got
play.
All of that, but Logan went for it.
You know, I think that if I'm Iolani, I'm staying away from Tui. I'm not setting his way. I'm not serving his way. I'm not doing anything. He's the guy with a hot hand right now. You know, they're gold going away from him.
He's got the mana going right now. Tyler Kubota back to serve his jump serve. Perfect pass by, and that's a middle quick.
You
hey,
know,
Harrison Lum is having a heck of a night.
Boy, I'll say. I think he's 3 for 4? The kid's hitting 750. But how about the pass by number 4, Charles Yoon?
Charles Yoon is doing he's passing about 950 out of 1,000.
And he was one of the keys to the match that Coach Mike
Perfect
said.
Perfect pass by Tui. Two up on Pitzer. They're gunning for him. Well, they're setting Tyler Kubota out of the back row. No setter. The libero's going to set. Back row to Colin Tseng, dug up by Tyler Kubota. And Tool, he's in front of the back.
Yeah, that's a good call.
Kekai cannot set the ball if he's in front. He cannot overhand set if he's in front of the 10-foot line.
Well, in that case, he was on the 3-meter line. And so, you know, that's a violation. It's okay if he was to bump set that. But, you know, he needs a teammate telling him, bump it.
Jump serve, Colin Tseng. That's about four feet out of bounds. Tui lets it back to serve. We got a sub in.
John Grubner coming back
Grubner's in. Grubner's back in. He's a big jumper. He's only about 6'2", Peter, but he flies. He climbs the ladder.
He sure does.
Tui's going for the short jump float. Looks like they're trying to position serve. High ball to Gabriel Vega. He's coming in early. That's dug up great. That's a pipe play by Tui. Tried to roll shot. That's not going to go down against six people. Logan crushes high hands.
Oh, they need a setter on this.
Yep, we got Kekai. Kupono. Faye, what a nice play by Kupono. Hey, he waited. That ball was a high set. He waited, gathered, and he unleashed.
And a great spot. He's putting it back in the percentage of the court. I think the number of balls that goes there is like 2% of the time. Balls go in that corner. So great play by him.
10 serving 10, and Tui serves out.
You know, I got to tell you, Tony, the flow of this game is favor of the Raiders.
I agree.
They're making plays. You know, Puno seems a little bit tight here. The Raiders have come in, and they're here to play. They're here to win. So,
It's a good chance to go to the middle here if it was me. And they did. They got a hand on it.
Nice call, partner.
Yeah.
Nice call.
They're keen on their outsides right now, but Tyler Cundiff's a force to be reckoned with. He's about 6'6", number 12.
We'll see what Clint Hamada does. See if he comes right back and, you know, battles, you know, with Tyler Cundiff in the middle.
Okay, Kai Nuhiva doing his ritual. The triple bounce and then the high toss with the jumpy. Perfect pass by Charles Yoon, outside back set to Logan. They're keying on Logan. They're keying on, that's just a bad, nobody stopped on defense, I think, Peter. They're all backing up when contact is made by Logan, but credit Logan Nowak with a great visionary shot.
Well, you know, you tell your guys, just put the ball in the middle of the court, you know, and then the defense has, you know, four or five guys that are all converging on it and taking each other's ball in that case. You know, Grubner or somebody was right standing right there, and Kekai is stepping in front of him.
Great serve, great pass.
Oh, my.
Great serve,
hit.
Great pass, great set, great dig. Oh, Logan Nowak, what a heck of a play.
That?
He is launching his body. He has no. That's another second, third dig of the game.
Oh, what a
Christmas
play.
With a set. Perfect pass by Ben Lamb. They're not going to set. They're going to go to Grubner. Another dig. That's the fourth dig in this play. What do we got?
Oh, we got a net.
We got
violation.
A 12, number 12, Tyler Cundiff.
My.
Hey, let's give a hand to everybody from Brett Christman to just everybody.
I gotta
heck,
tell
Peter.
You, that's a momentum changer right there.
12 all, we
right
got
there.
12 all.
That's, oh my goodness.
Lowell Tom, you don't see that too often, a five-dig rally. That's a perfect pass by Colin Sangin, a middle hit. You gotta love the paintbrush. It's the paintbrush, two up. You had your defense prepped, and it's a miss hit that just floats right over
you
the block.
You couldn't have asked him to put it in a more perfect spot than that.
That
great
was the
play.
Only spot.
Well, you know, the defenses, they get set up to take the hard-driven one. And a paintbrush like that, you know, is going to go down. The percentage are extremely high.
1,000%.
You know, so, yeah.
Back to serve. We got a new server. I'll check that. Ben Lamb with two up is getting dug. High ball outside. Colin Sang twists it down the line. And 15 came in with a great serve. Micah Goshi. And he caught them in trouble. Micah Goshi.
Oh, yeah. But how about the transition play by Colin Sang? This kid's playing great tonight.
There's two up, taking the angle, and he twisted it down the line right to the open spot. Kekai with a perfect pass. Ben Lamb's getting two up on him, Peter, every single time.
Yeah, and I like that Lowell's going back to him. You know, Eli got a touch out of the last one and whatnot. You know, I noticed that both coaches, they haven't used their timeouts. So we're almost at halfway through the game here. Both coaches got both their timeouts. This is going to get exciting here in the end.
13-14, Colin Parros with the jump floater. That's gobbled up perfect. That's a kind of a high ball. Looks like all the hitters, for me at least, maybe I'm a perfectionist, but they're coming in a little too early. And Ben Lamb's going to twist that.
We're going with a little 31 in transition there. They're starting to kind of spread things out, you know, a little bit. I like that. And you know what?
Lowell Tom takes
a whole lot of guts to be able to set that ball in transition at this point in the match by Lowell Tom.
It's nice to have two seniors that are setters that can actually be unfazed and throw that ball up there to perfection. Outside to Colin Sang. He whiffed it. Another paintbrush, no touch.
And you know what? This is where Colin Parros last time did not keep his serve in, and they had this kid. It was number 8 before Alden Wong, and now it's Micah Goshi
right.
that they're going after.
And they got him.
You know, it's a third
they
bad pass.
They got Goshi, and it's a decent enough set with nobody up. Brett Christman, he calls it. He was a wide receiver for the Elani football team this year.
Great play by him. You know, that's a great play by Puno to not block that. I wouldn't have blocked that play, but, you know, the back row's got to dig that. They got to come up with that play.
How hard is that ball to hit coming over your left shoulder on the right side to time it?
Only a beach player could do that.
Definitely. Kyle Kikina with a jump spin. Kekai nails that. Two up, and Kekai. Kyle Kikina. His hands
all over that thing.
I always tell my guys, ball-shaped hands. Keep them smaller. Ball-shaped hands. You get it to like a watermelon size. It's just too much space. The ball will pop right through. Danny Olson with the jump serve. Inches out of bounds.
Man.
That was close.
You can't be doing that at this stage of the game.
16 all.
You know?
This is a must-win set for Punahou Buff and Blue.
Give them area 6 right in the middle of the court. All right, we'll see what happens here. We're tied at 16. Clint Hamada back in with Logan Nowak in the front row.
Perfect pass outside. That's a tandem play. Tui just makes a
cagey
tip shot. Tui Leta like a senior.
You know, I like that Punahou is throwing, they're throwing some wrinkles in here. They run the 31 in transition. They're running Tui on a combo here. They're throwing something that Iolani maybe hasn't seen before, you know. Give them kind of an edge.
17-16, Tyler Kubota back to serve, perfect pass. Outside to Logan Nowak. He's going high corner. Great dig by Colin Peros, and Tui hits it out. Error. First error, I think. I don't know. I think his first error.
No, that's his second one. He hit one early in this game, but
17 all.
Yeah, you know, they were waiting for him over there.
I wouldn't be surprised they go right back to him. I'd do it, you know, a three to Pitzer and a back five if the pass is there. Going outside to Cupono, and he gets blocked, covered. Miscommunication. He's going to just roll shot that up.
Oh,
and Harrison Lum is fired up. That's a big block. You got Harrison Lum on the middle, Gabriel Vega on the right. Where do you go? You don't go into the block, that's for sure. You go over to the corner.
Well, this kid, Harrison Lum, is definitely the player of the game. I mean, he's played a fantastic game for the Raiders.
Perfect pass by Kekai. Miscommunication, but Harrison Lum, not only is his physical ability there, but the kid looks happy to be out there, and he's getting his teammates fired up.
Yeah, I mean, you know, he's out here doing what he's supposed to do, you know? He's playing a game. Let's have some fun with this thing.
You gotta love that. You gotta love that. Number 14, Tui Tui Leta back to serve. Freshman outside hitter. Short serve. Collins saying perfect pass. And Harrison. Harrison's pumped. He wanted that.
Yeah, but
he wanted it.
That was a good call. And you know what? I'd go back to him. I like the redo. You know, the set was kind of what we call a gap. He moved down the line from the middle blocker, and so he had some space. He just cut it too fine. It was a great play, a great set. You know, it's all right.
And it's good to see he doesn't get down. He knew he made a mistake. He never dwelt. Worst thing in volleyball is to dwell.
You
cannot think about the last play. You got to move on. You got five other your teammates to help you out on the floor. You're going to be fine. It's only 19-18. Puno is up by one. We'll see what happens.
Well, you know, Puno has had a couple of service errors early in this game.
Ooh.
You know, you had a sub come in recently and serve the ball out. Puno needs to, first of all, serve this ball in.
Yeah.
Iolani needs to make a great pass, you know, and run their middle again. Puno needs to be able to defend that and know that, hey, that's where they're going to go. That, you know, that they want to do that again, I think.
Spoken like a true coach. I think I remember I did a broadcast of your huddle, and that's like taken like from scripture right there. Peter Balding. Let's see. And I totally agree with everything you said. You've got to keep this ball in. Keep the pressure on them. Make them make the mistakes.
Well, good thing here is to serve in area three, which is short middle, force Logan Nowak to come up and pass and clutter the middle so that they can't. They cannot, you know, run the middle.
They did go to Logan. It's not a good pass, and that's an offset with no attack.
Puno's got to gobble this up.
See if they can capitalize. Tight set. Grubner. That's a net. But Grubner has such athletic ability. That was a tight set.
Yeah.
He's not going to broad jump under. He's jumping vertically up.
Yeah.
Wow.
Great play by him, and they need him to come on now. But I still here. I like them serving Logan Nowak right in the middle of where all the action's coming in and confuse things in there for the setter.
I'm wondering why they don't put Logan up. Peter, there it is.
There it is.
But they got a good run, but still, you got to keep the pressure on and make the other team make mistakes. 19 serving 20.
At 20, you got to put the ball in the court.
Yeah. Charles Yun, let's see. Senior, jump serve. Kekai, good pass to Pitzer.
Oh, my goodness.
Pitzer. Wow, what a connection. That's a gutsy set.
You know, it's incredibly gutsy because for the last 2 years, Brandon Pitzer, last 3 years of his career, he's been on the outside. He's a brand new middle this year. They convert him into middle because they didn't have, you know, a seasoned middle that they felt. So great play by him to get around the setter and hit that.
And he contacted that thing with some fervor. Kekai Nuhiva.
Gutsy.
Wow. Charles Yoon, you don't see that too often by him tonight.
Yeah, they're going to call timeout again, I think.
I think they will.
Yeah, there you go.
Michael Mong is no fool. It's not his first rodeo.
Hey, but you know what? This is a good rotation for Iolani. They got their three big guys up there. They got Tyler Cundiff in the middle, coming in the middle. They got Gabriel Vega on the outside, on the left side here, and then they got Logan on the right, which is his stronger side.
There's options, so that's a fun thing to be a setter out there, to pop it around.
Yeah, you
for
know.
For me, my set, my go-to set, if I was Iolani, got to go to Logan. I'm going to Logan.
And you know, I like to play, I like them calling a 31 to decoy Cundiff away.
Yeah.
Take Punahou's middle, in this case, Ben Lamb, away from so that Logan is going to be one-on-one on the outside here.
Let's see.
So we'll see what they do coming out here. But they got to pass the ball, Tony.
Yeah,
they don't pass this ball. They can't do anything.
Well, they got Charles Yun, Colin Tsang. I'd move Vega up, get him out of there, and just keep it less cluttered.
You know, I'm surprised that the Buff and Blue have not been serving short.
Yeah.
You know, especially in a rotation like this, force Logan to have to come in and pass that ball either, you know, an area two or an area three, kind of muddle things up in the middle there, you know,
right,
and not let them get a big run on it. We'll see. Here we go.
Let's see the pressure cooker, Kekai Nuhiva. He can handle it. Senior. Perfect pass by Colin Tsang, and they're going outside to the big guy. You got to feed the big guy.
Oh, man.
Gabriel Vega, he's hard to time. It looks like they don't get the correct timing on their block. He's jumping early. He's coming in late.
Hey.
Unorthodox, we call that.
Yeah, but you know what?
Effective.
It's effective. You know? Shows how much we know coming out of that time.
Really? Logan back to serve with a crushing. That's an overpass.
Uh-oh.
And 21 serving 20. I think Coach Toon does have one timeout left.
Yes, he does. And you know what? I'd call it now. Keep
zip it out. No, he's got two. He's got two, in fact.
Yeah, and you know what? I would cut. I think that's a great call because you don't want these guys to get even with you.
Right.
You know, and the other thing is it puts a little bit of pressure on Logan. He had a great jump serve there where he kind of put some heat on it.
After this timeout, he's told, like we are saying to everybody in webcast land, to keep the ball in play. Just a friendly reminder, guys, that Saturday night, Punahou versus MiraCosta and Iolani versus Santa Barbara in Clash of the Titans starting at, I believe, 5 o'clock. So that will be on the podcast.
Yeah, and you know what? That's going to be a great thing, Tony. You got these two great teams out of Hawaii playing two great teams out of California. MiraCosta won the Best of the West tournament, a tournament that Punahou won last year, and Santa Barbara finished tied for seventh in that. So you got two really great programs coming into here. So
this is a great warm-up for both these squads. I want to thank Yuri Biersock, the director, Brock Santi, Cole Wright, Andrew Ryan on camera, sound mixer Zach Parley, web producer Kapena Chi, and floor producers Nina Wu and Alexis Kanashiro. Back to the action. Tip shot by Ben Lamb.
Oh, what a play.
Wow.
Golly.
The wing front row diggers, Peter. If they're not blocking, what are they doing?
They got to be playing that. Both the left front and the right front have got to converge on that. And you know what? Credit goes to Ben Lamb. He's been, you know, toiling in the middle for 3 years and has not had that shot. And now as a senior, he's got it. And look at that, what happens at a crucial time.
Colin Tsang, perfect. Great dig by Lowell Tong. Bump set to Griff. I'm going to call him.
Yeah, Griff is. Griff. That's what the kids call him. They call him Griff. There's a touch on Tui in the back row here. We're back to 1 point differential here.
Who got that kill? Was that Chrisman or Cundiff?
I think it was Gabriel Vega.
Vega got it.
So you got Ian Wong coming in here now this time. This kid hasn't played all night.
Junior, let's see what he does. He's got the quadruple dribble and the floater handled decently by Grubner outside set.
Oh my,
wow,
what a clutch.
Griff.
You know, this kid Griff Bolin, he is the top water polo player. Doesn't play a whole lot of volleyball, but he's a clutch performer, so he knows of it. Okay,
wow.
So we'll see here if Colin Perros goes after the sub who came in that serve there.
Yeah, and he does. It gets it right to him. This perfect pass outside. Colin Tsang came in.
Oh, my.
We're going three sets here, Peter.
Oh, I'm surprised
we're going
at that.
Three. Wow.
Hey, but you know what? I got to hand it to this kid. Colin Tsang, you know, it didn't bother him. You know, he's laughing over here, but you know what? Hey, they'll come right back.
They will be back, and hopefully we can get either interview of Dan Fisher or Jeff Hall to come join us. They're assistant coaches of UH men's volleyball.
Here you're looking at some of the Punahou intermediate girls cheering on the Punahou boys. You're looking at Kiani Tuileta, who is the younger sister of Tuileta. We got a coin toss between Logan Nowak and Tyler Kubota. Looks like
they're gonna switch sides. No love lost there. I didn't see too many exchanges of happiness there. Each team wants to win in their own way. We got the Iolani contingency moving over. Sydney Art saying hi to me. Sydney Kikina, I should say. And looks like that interview is not gonna happen between Jeff Hall and Dan Fisher.
Yeah, that's all right. You're looking at, the team's changing sides.
The band is rocking. Looks like we have an alumni band. Peter can maybe get a shot of that. We have, I definitely don't think they're still in high school. I don't, just correct me if I'm wrong.
No, and you know what? Those guys, they show up at all these great matches between Punahou and Iolani. And, they're here to help out the group there. And so you see Toon here. He's getting the boys fired up. He's getting them antsy. You see Josh Taylor in the middle of that. Josh Taylor not able to play this year. He repeated his ninth grade year, so he can't play as a senior. You're looking
at the
Iolani group over here, kind of talking strategy. In the middle of that huddle is Alan Rosehill. Here's one for
Rosie.
You. Alan Rosehill was a Punahou Buff and Blue alum who played on the 1972-73 first state champion team.
Was that with Scott Metcalf?
Scott Metcalf, also on that team. Scott Metcalf's the gym manager there. You know, special shout out, you know, Tony, we've got a lot of people to thank, you know, for this, you know, to the peeps in the athletic office, the Karen Satterwhite and the Erica, Erica, her last name skips me, but, and Kenny Chu, you know, coming over. We got a little interview going here with Dan Fisher.
We got Dan Fisher, associate head coach, UH men's volleyball. My colleague on the UH men's volleyball staff, and excited to hear from Dan Fisher. He's gonna come over and join us. Right now, we're gonna get a headset on him. And you'll find out. Welcome, Dan Fisher. Great to have you. Looks like you and Jeff Hall are, Dave showed you're all there checking out this the scene. Tell me what you think about the play here tonight.
Well, the level's been good. You know, when you come straight from a college practice, the first thing you see is they're a little smaller than all guys. But you got to love the passion and you got to love the rivalry, don't you?
Definitely, and something to look forward to. I know that you guys are playing USC Friday, Saturday. Tell me about that.
Well, after this game, I'm gonna go home and watch some more video on SC, but they've been clearly the best team all year, running a real fast offense. And so we're gonna have to be prepared for them.
For sure.
Defensive team.
Hey, what kind of adjustments do you look to these guys to make in this next game here, this final match here?
Well, I've been chit-chatting it up so much, I don't know if I can give you the breakdown on these guys.
Sorry, I didn't mean to put you on the spot.
But
there.
He's got something for us.
Well, you're looking at both of these guys, you know, they've both been pounding in the middle because you got Tyler Cundiff and Ben Lamb going at the middle. It seems like, you know, when they're passing the ball well, they're going in the middle and trying to establish that. If you were on either one of their bench, would you continue to do that? Would you try to spread things out a little bit?
Well, I think you're right. I have watched enough to know the middle's been very effective. So, you know, I know Rick Toon likes to read block primarily. We'll see if he throws in a few commits here in the third set. But yeah, ultimately it's going to come down to serving and passing as it usually does.
Well said, Coach. Exactly.
All right, Dan. Thank you very much for stopping by.
Thanks, boys.
And good luck Friday night. I'll see you on the bench. Tui with the big block there.
And as we speak, they go after the middle, and you see that Iolani gets two guys committed and over on that. Oh, there he is again. Harrison Lum with a block along with Logan Nowak.
Okay, Peter, explain to me now, is this a game to 15 or are we going to 25?
This is to 25 here.
Okay, tight pass. Griff gets a, we get a knuckle cover by Kekai, back set to Tui. Kind of a smart play. Logan handles that easily, kind of confusion there, and Logan's just gonna twist it down the line. Perfect dig by Grubner, and
oh, what pitcher. A dig.
Nice dig. We got our new guy in here, number five, is Ian Wong. Ian Wong's back in, Pete.
Ian Wong's making some great plays. You know, Iolani's making a, they've kind of changed their block here. They're leaving Logan Nowak out on Tui and bringing Colin Tseng over on the right side here.
Overpass by Grubner, and Logan's gonna just crush it down the line. Yes. Tyler Kubota didn't have a chance. That was a well-hit ball.
Exactly, and you know, Iolani's got 3 points and Logan Nowak's touched all three balls. Huh. He's got 2 kills. One stuff block. So great move by Michael Mong on the adjustment there to get Logan on Tui.
Not the best way to start a third set. We got Tui getting dug straight up without a problem. Colin Tseng's not going to get a swing on that. Grubner's going to go quick, a little bit too quick of a ball. And Tui's getting dug, and Logan played that up perfectly.
Oh, what a play.
What a play. Pitcher could put that down.
What a play by these two teams. And you know, Mike talked to me. He called it the rat-a-tat. You know, we got to be able to make those rat-a-tat plays and whatnot. And I think that if they're winning those points, they were winning those points in game one, and they weren't in game two, and it was a slight difference to the, in the outcome.
Wow, that's a heavy bomb. Hey, that cannot be a freshman jump serve. That's ridiculous. I haven't seen a freshman jump serve like that since Hugh Foster.
Yeah, he's definitely lighting it up, isn't he?
Wow. He's got a good future.
Well, we'll see if he lights it up again.
He does, and he aces two in a row. Okay, we're back to 3-all, Peter. I don't know. It's either a great defense by Iolani or great jump serving by Punahou.
Hey, maybe we just need to listen to Dan Fisher a little bit more when he talks about serving and passing. You know, it's going to come down to serving and passing, you know?
I think Dan just told him to step back about a foot because he's bombing the back third of the court.
You know, I wonder if Dan is kind of already licking his chops at Tui in terms of him being a freshman, thinking, okay, I got to position myself here in the next couple years to make sure that we can
get
this guy.
Well, the whole staff is here from UH. If they're not here for him, I don't know who they're here for. Outside to Grubner. Grubner climbs a ladder. Wow, that's a big league hit.
Yeah, it is.
And
you know
goodness.
What? Little atonement because he had a bad pass to start the game here.
My goodness.
You know, we got a little different adrenaline going here in this third game.
Even in the sound booth here, up here, we're getting fired up here. People out there, thank you for joining us. It's live streaming all across America. I'm sure I've gotten calls from Seattle and San Francisco and even from Michigan. So thank you guys all for listening and taking part in this webcast. Outside to Vega goes over.
Oh, my.
Over and down.
Goodness,
that's a corner pocket.
Gracious.
Corner pocket.
You know, that kind of was reminiscent of a little Brad Lawson. Brad, I hope you're up in Stanford.
Brad.
You and Kavika are listening to this.
Wow.
Your boys are playing great. And,
they are.
A little reminiscent of the B-Rad.
B-Rad is right. Charles Yun back to serve. Okay, they're getting tight or they're... Are they? They can't be fatigued. They're all 18 years old. Don't tell me they're tired.
No, they can't. They're not fatigued.
No
I think they're trying just a little bit too hard right now. They got to go back to, you know, take a little, go the three-quarter swing, just put the ball in the court here. So
yeah. Take a breath. Lowell Tong. We got Vega. We got Cundiff and Nowak. This is your best position outside to Vega. He likes to go high hands.
Uh-oh.
I think Ben Lamb might have got a little ankle. And Tui,
Ben
sprained it.
He landed on Kupono Fei, I think.
He's going to walk it off. I think he's walking it off. Kupono, number 9. We got Ben Lamb, 13, and Sean Grubner in the front row versus Chrisman. If it was me, I'm going to go back overhead to Grubner to Chrisman's side.
Just you think?
Don't get me wrong. Oh, they did a fake switch.
My goodness
what
gracious.
What they call?
Chrisman was in the net. He had a sure point. He would have put him up 7-5, and now it's tied at 6-6.
Oh, that could be a game changer. That 7-5 lead could have easily gone to 9-5 within moments.
Well, you need those little ones.
Perros. Gabriel Vega. Gabriel.
You know, they got a little thing going here. You know, in this rotation, they've been serving area 1, which is that right back side of Iolani's. Colin Perilous has been kind of working that side of the court, and it's been paying off in this rotation. They're scoring points.
They're picking on Vega right now, but he just handles that like a man. And Chrisman's not. That was a little low set. Okay, that was a little bit of a low set inside set.
It was, but you know what, Tony? In this position, when the setter's coming out of the right back and you're serving it right where he's coming out of, it's a difficult ball for him to set it all the way out there. It's difficult for him to kind of find his middle.
For sure.
Because it's coming out of his blind spot.
Charles Yoon just shoved away Vega, which was a smart move because it enabled Cundiff to be unimpeded on his approach and just crush that ball.
Yeah, and you know what, Tui, they should have had two blockers committing on that because it was right in Tui's.
Right.
You know, and great play by Cundiff to hit it right where the blocker wasn't. So,
in my opinion, the hardest thing in volleyball, the two hardest things are blocking and passing. That's been my, just for me at least, maybe that's just for me. For some it might
be
the
easiest.
Well,
that's because you were a setter, for crying out loud. You never had to pass, but blocking, yes.
Blocking's difficult.
It's the most difficult skill to teach.
Yeah.
All right, so we'll see this rotation here.
We got a new server, Danny Boy Olson, number two, senior. Ben Lamb is out. Danny's going to play some defense. And we got Colin Tseng, Charles Yoon, or Ian Wong to pass this ball. He keeps that in, perfect pass. Cundiff's going hard. Two up, they got a net, something.
Somebody,
hey, they're
net.
Doing a neat little blocking scheme, so they got a commit on the one, and wow, they got two guys on the outside.
In. Yeah, they're not even worrying about Chrisman. They're just leaving him by himself, and they're committing their left side blocker to the middle, and so they've got two
they
bats
should,
on Colin Tseng on
nice
the outside.
Nice serve
here
by Danny in the middle. Danny Boy passes that up. Perfect. He missed. He slipped. Pitzer. Great cover. Great cover by Perros. And they're just going to pop it over Kupono Faye.
Oh, we'll see.
Charles
Yoon
came in. And that's outside set. And he hits it out.
Oh,
wow.
My.
That's a timeout possibility. 11-7. Peter,
yeah,
is this a timeout here?
You know, I think
opinion?
You got.
Yep.
Yeah, I think so. And you know what? He's got to go back to the middle in that and transition. You know, Cundiff is the guy who's making it happen. You know, run it inside out. Not, you know, Colin Tseng's had a great turn, a great match tonight. But in that situation, you finally get a good pass. Go back to Cundiff.
What we call that, you got to feed the beast. Feed
yeah.
the beast.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely.
Well, we got good crowd tonight. People are matriculating in nicely to Manoa Valley. It's cooled off a little bit. Nice shot of the brain trust. Nice shot of the crowd. Potential intermediate.
Now you're looking at some intermediate Punahou boys, you know, checking out the game and whatnot. Hey, I like Ilani coming out of this timeout and going back to the middle. You know, maybe, you know, they had Logan Nowak early come in on a combination. I'd like to see if they've got something, you know, dialed in for that with Colin Tseng. I think he can hit that, you know, whether they have that in their repertoire, you know, we'll see. But
right.
I definitely would like to see, you know, some sort of combination with those two guys.
With Danny Olson's gonna probably do a jump serve, not so hard, and should get a good pass out of this. So let's see if your theory holds true. Good pass, and they go outside. Not, what a dig, somebody's gotta get up.
Careful, oh, what a net. Play by Brandon Pitzer.
Pitzer with body control. Pitzer with body control. That
yeah.
outside hitting last year has enabled him to be a very athletic middle.
Yeah, and you know what? Shame on me. I thought Ben Lamb was still in the middle. Yeah, Eli's got to be going. They've
yeah.
lost 3 points here and not gone to Cundiff at all. And the pass has been good enough.
Charles Yoon, that's a missed time. And that's
great
a missed
play
Kupono.
By the libero.
Good set by Danny Olson. Tui's just going to roll shot to the corner. Outside, that's a wide set, that's just out. Good call, hey, you know what? These linesmen, they're calling it like they see it. That's good integrity by the Iolani linesman that was out, he called it out.
Yeah, and now,
mad
shoot,
respect.
If they get a good pass, now Punnell's gotta commit two guys in the middle on him, because they haven't gotten the ball to Cundiff yet.
Unless they go back set to Chrisman and fool everybody. Outside again, two up, and he chisels Kupono Faye. You can tell.
They
he
got confidence
balanced.
In that kid.
He wasn't balanced. He didn't press to the opposite corner. But heck, is he, Peter, check this. Is he a senior? Oh, he's only a sophomore. Kupono Faye.
Kupono
Faye
yeah,
is a sophomore.
Yeah, he's a sophomore. But Colin Tseng is a senior. Great play by him.
Jump serve Kyle Kikina. It's a warbler. Not a problem. Handled nicely. One-on-one. Kupono Faye is a sophomore. He's got some ability. He's a tall lanky kid.
You know, he's it's kind of in his blood.
It
you know,
is.
His nephew or his cousin is Micah Christensen, so he comes by it naturally.
Wow.
You know,
wow.
The athleticism that's in that family.
That must be nice. Nice. Tyler Kubota with his patented jump serve cross body. Back row set to Chrisman with a cut shot
like
his dad.
Oh, my goodness.
I got to mention something. Okay. Kurt Chrisman won 14 state championships with John Anderson on the beach. His son, Brett Chrisman, just made a patented Kirk Chrisman cut shot. Back to the action. I had to throw that out there. Clint Hamada. Nice pass by Colin Perros. Way back set. Tui just waiting for it. And that kid has range. He can hit on the left. He hits out of the pipe position. He can hit on the right.
Well, it's a great set by Tyler Kubota. He jacked that thing 25 Jeez. Feet back,
wow.
You know, to isolate him one-on-one out there. You know, Logan Nowak, I don't care how good you are as a blocker, you're at a disadvantage in that situation.
15-9, heavy topspin. Pass nicely by Logan. He's going to get fed the ball. And Logan hits out. That's unfortunate.
You know,
the kid is working his tail off to get his team to the best position he can.
Well, you're noticing that they're not passing as well as they did in games one and two.
Is it because the Punahou Buff and Blue are serving tougher? Possibly.
I think that they're going after it a little bit more, yes. So.
Nice. Colin Singh is unfazed. He just crushes balls into the block. I like when kids don't avoid the block and they hit into the block hard. Because you never know. You're going to get blocked,
you know,
you might
Scott
get a
Riggs,
rattle.
Scott Riggs says, hey, the block is your friend. Go ahead and bang at it, you know.
Scott Riggs, he is a chiseler. I remember seeing him play. Great pass by Tui. He's got strong hands. And I shook his hand today, Peter. And I'm telling you, the kid has some big, big meat hooks. Grubner.
Well, he comes by
Grubner.
It naturally, partner.
Yep. Oh, that's a good pass by Tui again. Outside set to Grubner. High hands, great dig by Colin Singh. Oh, that's a tight set. Logan could only knuckle it over, and I'm seeing a little bit of life. 11 serving 16. You gotta love those standing knuckle, non-jumping kills.
Well, here it is. You put it in the middle of the court, and you let a couple of guys fight over it, and this is what happens. So you get Kekai Nuhiva and Tyler Kubota fighting for it.
Colin Singh serves that out. Not a good time.
And down five in the third game.
Yeah.
The momentum's on the other side of the net. You gotta try and keep the mo on your side. You gotta try and get it back on your side,
yeah,
I should say.
For sure. Good passing pattern here. Colin Singh, Yoon, and Logan. Bad pass. They're gonna have to go to Vega outside, and he'll detonate. Pretty good dig. Tyler Kubota is like on a track team.
Oh my.
Grubner,
what a dig
by Colin Singh. Logan's gonna roll it. Tui's gonna pass that as
what
a nail, and that's down. Just out. I saw that just out, but is that?
Well, the whole Iolani team
saw it.
You know, it's right in front of the official. Head
okay.
official right there. He's saying it.
Yeah.
You know, but
I can't see it. I'm up here, but you know what? That was a great play all the way around. It's a great dig by Sang. Great play by Tui. Tui throws it up right in the middle, and Ben Lamb just absolutely crushes that ball.
You know, it seems like Punahou is kind of, they put a little bit more kind of pace on everything in this third game. They're playing with a little bit more urgency. They're putting a little bit more heat on their serves and forcing Iolani to kind of not get quite the pass that they've been experiencing, the good pass they've been experiencing games one and two. So the sets to the outside, or they're not able to go to the middle. The sets to the outside are not quite there. So it's a combination of things that are, you know, have got the Buff and Blue ahead by seven in the third
right.
game.
And it's always good when you get that kind of early lead. You know, 3-0 up, you're going to go for it. You're going to have that arm swing more free. You're going to pass a little bit with more confidence. You're going to set the ball, take a little bit more chances. That's the beauty of having a lead. And also, both of these coaching staffs are exceptional. You got Michael Mong, Alan Rosehill, and his assistant, which I didn't catch his name. You got Rick Toon, Stein Metzger, and Brandon Kikuchi. And a big block. They knew it was going back. They had four hands over.
Well, I think that they came out of the timeout. It was like, hey, we're going to stay with Logan no matter what. And I think that's a good play. The other assistant is Brandon Flores on the Iolani team.
Okay, Brandon Flores. So that, I mean, they have, that's a bad pass.
Yeah, miscommunication there by
Charles Yoon and Logan.
Yeah, not good.
I think Logan, I know, well, he's in the front row. I would try to get him out of the passing so he can be freed up to hit, but they're just going right to that zone. That's a perfect pass again outside of the big guy. And he hits a high, hard ball. He really, really gets his feet there now, and he's hitting hard.
Yeah, you know, he's wow. getting up pretty good. Impressive. And that's not something that you can practice too many times against. You know, a guy at 6'7 with arms that, you know, go down to his knees. So
yeah, Charles Yin back to serve. Good front row. Logan Nowak, Vega, and Cundiff. And a middle set. Ben Lamb is he's on fire.
Yeah, and you know what? He's going one-on-one against Tyler Cundiff. You know, both those guys going one-on-one against each other, the advantages to the offensive player. He's got to get some help from Gabriel Vega.
He's got to pinch in and help a little bit. Back to the action. Back to the action. We got Lowell Tong serving out. Not an appropriate time. You know, here's my take. You're up 21-12. You're going to probably not agree with me. But the floater like that is going to be so easily passed. Why not just serve it hard and in? If it goes out, then that's fine. But you're serving it so easy that even if it's passed, it's going to be a perfect pass. That's just me.
I agree with you.
Oh, wow.
But the kid, he doesn't have that serve in his repertoire. Okay. So he's not going to serve it. Okay, this one's going to area one here.
Colin Parros, left-handed floater. He's going in. Serve it out. That's not out. That's way out.
This is getting ugly here. You know, these guys are trying too hard here to make it perfect. You know, it's just
14 serving 22. There is no time limit. However, this is a rally scoring game. You score every single time you ball hits the floor. Not old school. This is new school. Tough serve with a floater. Perfect pass. Middle set to Ben Lamb.
Great off-speed play by him. Great off-speed. He had two blockers camped on him. You know, he saw that they were taking his away shot. And, you know,
he came on in the third. He's gangbusters right now. But I think, you know, in my opinion, Tui Tuileta has kind of been the glue that's held this house together.
Well, he was good in games one and two, wasn't he?
Yes, he was. And he's consistent right now. He's going high hands.
Oh, what a dig by Yun.
What a dig, Charles Yun. That's a one-hand stab, and that's out.
Oh, that's too bad. That's too bad. That was a great dig by him. You know, Colin Tseng did the best he could to try and get hands.
Might as well. Danny Olsen back to serve, 24. This is match point. Let's see who they go to. Two up on the outside, and Doug, and we got a net there. We got a net.
Yeah, it looked like the two Buff and Blues kind of banged into each other and then, you know, banged into the net.
There's
as well.
Still life. So. We got Kyle Kikina, sophomore. This is a pressure cooker situation. 15
yeah,
serving 24. I mean, he could rattle off two or three aces right here.
Yeah, but you need, you know.
You need about
he's
needs
nine to tie it. So,
well,
you know.
I've seen things happen. He's a stud. He gets one in. Perfect pass by Kekai. And they're going to go one up. And Kupono Fei with the good swing.
Oh, we got
overrule. It's out. I believe it was out.
Well, you know, the Ilani Lions person, he called it in. And the head ref, all the way across the court, he called it out. So I like the play, though. Nice looking
That's
play.
That's another good serve.
Oh.
Hey.
Maybe. Oh. You never know.
You never know.
Here he is. Mr. Clutch, Kyle Kikina.
Footsteps.
You know, he's got kind of that swag to him.
He does.
He's always got that little walk. You know, you see him at the beach kind of.
He's a little stud.
He poked a couple of squid, you know.
Oh, and then he serves out. Oh. Hey, that's unfortunate that it ends that way. But in my opinion, what a match, Peter. We were excited up here.
Great
Punahou
match.
Punahou prevails 25-17. And we'd love to get Tuileta as our player of the game. Do a quick interview with the kid.
Hey, you know, I look forward to seeing both these teams again on Saturday, you know, because they're gonna represent the state of Hawaii well, playing against those two tough California teams that are coming down. You know, they're right in the middle of their league and playing some tough competition. And so, you know, this will be good. You know, we'll get to see them again. So,
number one, MiraCosta. They're pretty tough. They were number one when I was a senior in high school. Brian Ivey, Eric Fanoimoana, Dan Greenbaum.
Well, those
Carl Hankel.
Those are some names out of the past, you know. I mean, Fenoy Moana, he went on to win a gold medal at the Olympics, so, you know.
Yeah, they played Team Reebok, and if we could get Tui, number 14, over here, that would be excellent. Thanks to everybody. Just reminding, Saturday night we will be having a live broadcast streaming, Puno versus Miracosta in the first game, and Iolani versus Santa Barbara. So I think Miracosta is number one, and Santa Barbara's tied for seventh in the nation. Want to shout out afterwards. We're going to give a little quick interview. Tui Tuileta. Get him settled up and mic'd up. Tui, fantastic game. Now tell me, what was the feeling going through your head being down one set, coming back, winning the second, going into the third set? Were you nervous or were you just feeling confident?
Oh, we were all actually really nervous, but we all just had to pull it together. And we knew that Iolani was a good team and we knew it wasn't going to come easy to us. So we just had to just go back to our basics, just do the things we do the best, and just come out to win this match.
Explain to me something. Were you calling for the ball a lot? Like, I noticed you and Ben Lamb were getting a lot of sets. In the middle of the play, do you just actually verbalize to the center, say, I'm ready, set me? Or is it a pre-planned thing that they're gonna set you?
Oh, well, it depends on the pass, you know, because we have great passers, and if we have a good pass, then it opens up the whole offense, and it's basically the center's decision to read the blockers on the other side of the net to get the ball and hit the ground.
Hey, tell us a little bit about what was going on in the huddle between games one and two, the adjustments that you made, you know, because you guys came out and kind of did a little something different, you know, in game two, and then in game three, you know, you put the foot on the gas pedal and took off. Tell us a little bit about what you know, Rick and Stein were telling you guys in those huddles.
Well, first game was kind of like a wake-up call for us. It was a tough loss for that first game, so we just had to come back to our huddle, and then we basically just talked about, hey guys, we gotta stick together. We can't stay apart and just become individuals. We have to play as a team. We have to get good passes. We have to just win this whole thing as a team, and everything just came our way at the end because we all came together and it all fit into one.
Hey, and you did great. You know, I mean, this is your first kind of, you know, big tight match as a freshman. Tell us a little bit about how some of your club experiences has kind of prepared you for a match of this magnitude. Because you came out firing on all cylinders, no doubt about it. So tell us a little bit about that, you know, that off-season stuff that you do in the summer and whatnot, how that's helped you.
Summer, I have great coaches. You know, I got Pono Ma'a and I got Charlie Jenkins, and they really just focus on the little things that make a big difference in our play. And it was really, they're who made me, they're who made our team, and they're the people who made all the good players, and it was just, I just had to do what I had to do best for the seniors, and that was just win this match, because I want the seniors to have a really, really good year this year. And then I came here to school, and they really just put all the puzzle pieces together for us to make a good team, and we ended up playing very good today.
Well, congratulations.
Congratulations. It's great to see the youth. It's a ninth grader. You play with such swagger, and we really like to watch you playing and look forward to watching you play a lot more in the future. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Well, Peter, are we still on? If we are, congratulations to Punahou Buff and Blue. It's been a great night working with you, Peter. And to everybody out there that helped out with this webcast that I named up, Yuri Biersak, Brock Santee, Cole Wright, Andrew Ryan, Zach Parley, Kapena Chi, Nina Wu, and Alex Kanashiro. Mahalo, Peter.
Thank you, Tony. It was an honor. A little shout out to my daughter, Lizzie, who's in Willamette in Salem, Oregon. We'll hopefully watching this telecast, and you know, look forward to seeing you folks on Saturday when Corona Del Mar and the Dons of Santa Barbara come to play. Oh, Miracosta. As they come to play the Buff and Blue and the Raiders of Iolani on Saturday.
To all our listeners out there in podcast land, thank you so much. Much aloha and take care.